What's up, YouTube? I'm Valentin the Mad, and this is a good review of Fallout 4. So this is a review I was really looking forward to do. I played New Vegas and really enjoyed it, but not the combat side of it. I liked the exploration and the large variety of ways you could approach every task, but when it came to actually shooting stuff, it just wasn't that fun. Part of that is the response on the receiving end, which has been very lacking. The dismemberment was nice, but that's about it. Bullet wounds didn't always work. The animation responses were very poor. The blood spitting was bad. And of course, you had the bullet sponge characters. I'm not even talking about Deathclaws. Near them every character had an inflated health bar. Well, did things change? What was improved? Let's find out. I'll be reviewing every aspect of the game's gore effects, and the score will be set based on 4 categories. Body damage, environment, animations and sounds, the feel. One of the new features in Fallout 4 is dynamic dismemberment. It works only on the limbs, but it is pretty cool. The limb can be dismembered almost anywhere you shoot it, with the exception of hands and feet. However, the looks themselves aren't very gory, and there's very little blood splatter around the amputation. Also, once you cause it, you can't dismember the limb further, which is a shame. I was looking forward to slicing limbs like salami. As for other dissection, the head can be dismembered or destroyed. The looks of that are also way too clean, with pretty much no blood splatter. The torso has a variation of complete annihilation, which actually looks awesome. You would think this nuke would be enough to cause it, but the bastard needed more beating with the machete. Classic Fallout logic. As for non-dismemberment body damage, you have bullet wound decals for gunfire and knife attacks. Yep, that causes bullet wounds too. The decals actually look really nice. Not incredibly gory, but not bad either. Now by default, there is a limit of 1 wound per body and bullet wound decals disappeared in 30 seconds. The Defender 1 posted a fix for it in his Enhanced Blood Textures mod. It makes both bullet wounds and other blood decals stay for as long as you set it. You can find the link to it in the description below. In case you were wondering about blunt weapons, those will dismember limbs but cause no other visible damage. The first trailers of the game showed breakable armor, and that got me quite excited. So how does it work? You have an armor piece for each limb, the chest and the head. Once a piece takes enough damage, it gets destroyed. Breakable pieces work only when the character is wearing power armor. Characters wearing other types of armor will have no such function. Also, there is no visible damage for those armor pieces. Either it's there, looking intact, or it is destroyed. And once the armor piece is destroyed, there is no further visual damage. The base of the power armor will not show any response. So as you can see, the breakable armor is very limited and does not deliver. As for the burning, the body damage for it looks really bad. Technically, it is a step up over nothing at all that we had in New Vegas, when it works. Also, you have no animations as a potential redeemer. Characters are absolutely unaffected by the flames and just die when the health points run out. On shots at the characters, a bloodstain may or may not appear, and that is all the blood splatter you have in the game. The stains are not remotely proportional to the huge blood puff effects, and you will see blood spilling that doesn't stain anything. In the gore view of New Vegas, I mentioned that the spinning mechanics need to be scrapped and rewritten. That didn't happen. The only thing that was changed is the looks of the bloodstains. And just like in New Vegas, all of the mess can be configured to stay. Pieces of destroyed heads and limbs stay for as long as the body stays, and bodies stay for a ridiculously long time by default. And as I mentioned previously, bullet wounds and other bloodstains can stay for as long as you configure them. Permanent blood and bodies are the easiest 10 points a game can get in the gore reviews. It's only a matter of configuring a few values on PC, but the difference it makes is huge. Even when the blood spinning mechanics are bad, it still matters. War never changes, and some things about Fallout don't seem to change either. The animations aspect and the damage model are still a complete mess. There are several specific instances in which you will see response animations. They are certain attacks by the dog and crippling a body part. If you shoot a character without crippling anything, you will see no animations. Fallout 4 has death animations though. While they are not long or impressive, it still feels much more natural than the insta ragdoll we had previously. Changes of behavior for wounded characters also have very specific conditions. If you cripple a character's leg, they will start limping, and if you dismember a ghoul's leg, they will fall on the ground and start crawling. The issue is that this is all. Unless you shoot the legs, characters will not have any changes to their behavior. A character on the verge of death will run around like nothing happened until you punch them in the face and they will insta-die. To avoid that, the game would need several wounded states of behavior. The bare minimum should be a wounded state in which the character can still fight but struggles to move regardless of where you shoot them, and a disabled state for badly wounded characters. And here's the thing, your companions kind of have a disabled state and can be revived by a steam pack. Why not have a similar function for enemies too? As for the damage model, Fallout 4 is a complete clusterfuck of values. How much damage does the gun deliver? How much damage will it deliver in your hands? How many health points the enemy has? How will the coat he is wearing affect the damage? The result is that most characters in the game are bullet sponges in one way or the other and can take much more damage than they should. From regular grunts who can survive a headshot, to legendary characters who can absorb ridiculous amounts of damage. What you get is that guns simply don't feel like guns. I'm not talking about realism. Repetitive shooting at the same target while seeing little to no response on their side is simply not fun, no matter how you look at it. So here are my suggestions. First, weapons should make sense. A gun is a gun, and it will deliver serious damage to a human character who is wearing weak armor or no armor at all. A legendary character can be very accurate, fast and smart, but a bullet to the brain will still stop him. The biggest difference between the improvised guns and the well-built ones would be accuracy, range and reliability, not double damage. The personal skill about guns would be accuracy, and not how much damage does a bullet deliver. Characters like super mutants or ghouls could take more damage than a human, as long as their behavior will change as they are getting wounded and their health bar is still reasonable. Armor needs to have better visual response and a bigger role in the game. It may take hits for a character, but you should see it get damaged and break off. Damage to heavy armor needs to be dynamic and have several layers. You could potentially have bullet sponge characters, but there wouldn't be any problem with that if the visual armor damage provides decent response. Unarmored damage sponges, such as Deathclaws, would need more detailed mutilation to provide visual feedback. The main idea behind those suggestions is that common sense can have place in a role-playing game, and these two things do not contradict each other. You can have enemies of varying difficulties, but the means to achieve that don't have to be underpowered weapons and unresponsive characters. The sounds are actually pretty good. The response sounds on impact are nice, and the sounds you will hear on dismemberment are awesome. Characters will react in pain, make sounds on death, and will comment on what's going on. While it could be more lively and brutal, the sound aspect delivers and by no means feels lacking. Fallout 4 is an example of how body damage alone is not enough for a good feel. The dismemberment is neat and the bullet wounds mostly work, but it still is only one aspect. The spinning mechanics, the animation responses and the damage model are still bad, and those are just as important for a good experience. So the score for body damage is 14 out of 30. The score for environment is 13 out of 30. The score for animations and sounds is 16 out of 30. I give the feel a score of 3 out of 10. So this gives the core system of Fallout 4 a total score of 46 out of 100. Fallout 4 is more of the same in pretty much every way. You have the exploration part, which was and still is awesome, but the response mechanics also haven't changed much. The improvements to the core system from Game 3 and New Vegas have been minimal, and that is really disappointing. The game was in development for a very long time, and I honestly expected more. However, Bethesda's games are very moddable, and I will make videos about mods that improve the core mechanics. If you run into a good mod I haven't discussed, please let me know. Hope you enjoyed watching the review. Let me know how you feel in the comment section, and if you like the video, subscribe and share it with your friends. You can find the link to all of my GO reviews in the video description. Until next time!